Hey everybody, hope you're having an awesome day and an awesome week. I wanted to introduce Tyler Albacher. He is our repeat guest, and we're literally like our one-year anniversary coming up here on the Agents Who Win show. I'm Todd Schroth, running the Agents Who Win Friday show, and I just wanted to bring Tyler back because we are doing an event in person with him in August, and this is kind of like a segue into what's going to be provided. And as we're all excited to get back out and like get engaged with front of people and get back in these live events and, you know, keep them small and intimate so everyone's like comfortable. But Tyler, you know, I appreciate you jumping back in with us and excited to have you coming up here in Orlando next month to kind of dive into us about some video things you have going on.
Absolutely, Todd. I really appreciate you having me on again. It's crazy. It's been literally 1 year since our last session here. So I'm excited to just give back. I've learned a lot, you know, in the past 12 months. We had a huge Dippity Deep Dive virtual conference. We had Gary Vee as our keynote speaker with Tom Ferry and Jason Pantana, and a lot of takeaways from that conference that has really led me down a path where, you know, to double down on the importance of video marketing. And that is the number one way to grow your business and grow your brand. And I'm just excited to really package this into the ultimate, you know, video marketing playbook for the real estate industry. We put together a 30-day challenge also with it. So I'm super excited for you guys to actually get the very first, you know, peek at it and really, you know, get the value from it and really give it a go because it's very valuable. We put a lot of time and effort and energy into it. So like I said, this is the number one way to grow your business. And I think there's no better time to do it than right now. So,
you know, that's awesome that you got Tom Ferry and Gary Vee on there. And video has been a big segue for many years, yet it's sad that we're still talking about it because people should just get out and do it. And it's like, you know, now it's like video because more people want to see it. And now we can do the script at the bottom of the video so people can read it versus watch it. But they want something to watch. They want something to listen to versus the long vlogs. So I think this is going to be great for you.
As the times change, the way we consume content changes, right? So, you know, it's no different. It's just the mediums have changed and our attention spans have changed. And now there's new platforms like TikTok and, you know, what's a streaming platform? I'm not a gamer, but Twitch. Both of those have just, you know, elevated the importance of video to communicate, you know, not only just externally, but also internally. So, you know, like for yourself, Todd, like, you know, and any broker or any team leader, like anyone that's managing other people, if you can put together video series that, you know, communicate effectively what you're trying to get through to your team or your staff or to whatever audience you're looking to, you know, reach, that there's no better way to do it than video. So that's the way that we're consuming content. That's the way that we naturally are communicating as humans. So I think, you know, the proof is in the pudding. And now, you know, part of the playbook is explaining the importance of video. So, you know, you guys will see it, but the first steps or the first parts of it is just, you know, explaining the importance, how video marketing has grown over the last 2 to 3 to 5 years. You know, the data is there. Now, like you said, Todd, it's time to actually execute. And that's the biggest challenge that everyone has that we speak to as business owners or, you know, agents, team leaders. It's just you have to delegate and you have to have the time. You have to have a purpose with your content. So, you know, just, you know, seeing all the people in the industry and just compiling different content pillar ideas in this playbook as part of the challenge, I think it's going to really help at least get the ball rolling for many people who have kind of, you know, have stumbled upon like or question about what to post or, you know, where do I start or, you know, everything that we're going to be talking about can be done with a smartphone. All you need is an iPhone and all you need is time and a strategy. So we hope that, you know, we have everything for everyone to start executing. And then at that point, this 30-day, you know, calendar is rinse and repeatable. So, you know, I want everyone to not only take these ideas, you know, with a grain of salt for 30 days, but, you know, take the content pillar ideas and repeat it for the next 30 days. Keep that momentum, you know? So I'm just,
One of our coaches, when we were at his event 2 years ago, he's like, all right, here's a 30-day challenge. I want you guys to all go out. And you cannot come back in this room unless you've recorded a video. So we had to show them the Facebook Live that we did. I thought that was an awesome way to get people actually, you know, you spend $1,000 to go to an event, and within the first couple of hours, they say, go record a video outside. Or no, don't record. Go do a video outside because it's live. And if you don't show us one that you've done, you can't come back in here. You're out of the conference. And, you know, great accountability. But it's like, you know, then to keep it up, I think, you know, for me, it's always about what do I say? And so often, I was just at a Cheplak event, and where he's walking around the room talking, all of a sudden he busts out his phone. He's like, you know, does this with his phone and does a quick recording. And he's like you said, all you need is an iPhone. He goes, you know, those videos that I send, they're my iPhone and a $3 tripod. So what do you mean you need a big fancy camera crew?
Yeah, you should actually see exactly what I'm recording my laptop on right at this very moment. So there's so many excuses that people have out there. But again, what it boils down to is having a roadmap. So, you know, I think exactly what you said, you have to have a strategy in place. So this playbook is going to give exactly, you know, the ideas and the pillars for people to execute on. And then it's about keeping that momentum up, like I said. So. The biggest thing also is accountability. So like you said, the event, that was a great idea. So as part of this challenge also is going to be coupled with our Facebook group, where people have to post about, you know, their videos and get feedback and just use not only Dippity as a resource, but everyone, you know, their peers, just to get constant feedback and, you know, criticism or just critiques. You know, that's how we get better. So,
yeah. It would be funny at the event if everyone said, you know, go outside, record your video, tag us, and we'll refund your money for coming, because it's, you know, the accountability for coming to the thing. Not saying I'm going to do that, but I think it'd be a great segue. You know, maybe we throw that out as an option when people get there.
At least something where, you know, there is an incentive. Maybe you get entered into winning something, like, you know. I would definitely need to think about that idea.
Yeah, tag us on the video, and we'll wonder if you're a weekend away or, you know, whatever. We'll come up with something. Top Golf event or something. I'm sure we can get that coordinated.
Yeah.
But that would be a good accountability, because any of those things could, if it's giving you money back on the ticket, it's $20. You know, whatever. But Top Golf, $100. You know, a weekend away at a hotel, a couple $100. You know, I mean, I'll go record a video right now for you know, $20, because what does it take? 3 minutes, and it gets an audience going. Ooh. And it drives it up there. So if you don't mind, like, how is the video playbook tying into what Dippity's doing right now as a marketing company?
So, I mean, the video playbook is exactly the number one way that we are hearing that clients are starting conversations and, you know, having positive feedback with their clients and their audience, you know, so. You know, it's no different. Dippity, you know, we focus on advertising efforts on Google and Facebook, and we create content on you know, our clients' websites. But we aren't necessarily there in person to record video content. We are actually working on a package or a service where we're actually doing, like, recorded Zoom calls like this, where we're chopping clips up and running those as ads. So it is something that we are, you know, seeing the need and the importance of. But what it boils down to is execution. And that is the biggest pain point in the entire process, is having the strategy, having the roadmap, but also then doing it, you know?
Yeah.
So that's, you know, again, once. And the other big part of the playbook that I'm excited about, not to segue too much, but we give people a list of the top agents to follow also. So we're giving you, you know, pillar content ideas, but we're also going to give you other agents to follow so you can get continuous ideas and just get your mind going. Because, you know, a lot of agents or people that I speak to, you know, they don't. Some don't like to look at others or, like, look at their competition. They look at it as competition. But, you know, I played basketball growing up, Todd, you know. So, you know, I view it no different than watching game film on another player. You know, you want to continuously get better. So, you know, we give, you know, a list of agents to follow. But at Dippity, some clients send us video content to run into their video ads. I'm sorry, into their Facebook ads or their Instagram ads.
Okay.
So, you know, video is like, you know, one of the best ways, if not the best way, to attract, engage, and delight your, you know, your audiences. And that's what we're finding with our clients. And that's the reason we put this entire playbook together, is just to lean into that. And then for us to help complement, because we do, you know, all the remarketing and all the geeky and nerdy stuff behind the scenes.
It's all the fun stuff. So like, yeah. Like Michael Jordan's the best basketball player, so, you know, LeBron James is always watching his videos to learn how to be as good as him. You know, so you want to take that and like, and just copy the footsteps, or how did he fly through the air so far? You know, I love watching our competition here locally on video to see what they're doing, because, you know, I'm going to be in a different audience than them. So, and if you're afraid of doing it in your market, go outside of your market, because you're not going to hit them then, if you're worried about them seeing your stuff. And yeah, again, change it by 10%. It becomes yours. You're not copying exactly. And it's never going to come across exactly unless you script word for word what they say.
Right.
Told us to go follow Tom Ferry's Facebook page and engage to see, like, you click here, then it takes you, you know, the click funnel version of it, and look at the ads that he's running. Cause it's like, so as we're doing recruiting, you know, using that type of funnel system, and they're using Tom as a prime example, cause he always has a great, like, free hook, and it's going to get people's attention.
Yep. Absolutely. Yeah. So, and I mean, no, you're absolutely right. And like Tom is a great example of that. But the biggest thing, you know, what I really want to stress to everyone is look at others as examples and guides to then use your own uniqueness, your content, right? So you don't have to, you know, you don't want to swipe and steal exactly someone's, you know, personality style or traits, but you want to get the ideas, the content pillar, you know, the content pillar bank, which is what we call it in the playbook. You know, we have I think it's 8 or 9 different series of content pillars that you can repeat week in and week out. You can layer it in Monday through Sunday, and you can use other posting systems where they can automate the posting for you. So there are ways to batch post this as well. But the biggest thing is consistency, and right, having the pillar ideas, and then not being afraid to look at others for, you know, as guidance. You know, look at those peers, like I said, study their playbooks. No different than studying film on players in sports. So, you want to get better.
Who are some of your top agents that you would recommend, or brand names to go follow if someone's going to follow somebody?
Well, we have a list of 30 in the playbook. So,
okay,
I'll give you
without saying the playbook names. Is there anybody outside of that you think is good to do?
Well, yeah, I mean, there's definitely some outliers in there, but I'll just give you a few that are in the playbook.
Okay,
Zachary Faust, Katie Day, Taya DiCarlo, Kyle Whistle.
Yep.
Tamika, there's a few, I don't want to give away too many, but what we did is we tried to not only get people also like Brad McCallum, who do like high quality listing videos. We also made sure, because this is more so for social media, like organic posting or just like, you know, continuous content for social media. So of course you can run these as ads, but part of the challenge isn't going out to doing a listing video. Everything here can be done with an iPhone and a gimbal, or just a regular, you know, handheld. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, the biggest thing is, you know, having the strategy, but having those ideas, having the people to follow, and having that 30-day calendar that you can use for the month of July or month of August, and then use it again for September and then October. But use those frameworks, those pillars, as those ideas. You can use your own flair and your own unique style. And I'm sure as you go through the playbook and go through the challenge, you'll see those other agents to follow. There's other content ideas that we didn't list, you know, that and there'll be new ones that we haven't even thought of. So we want you guys to use what we have as a roadmap or a blueprint, but you know, look at these other, you know, shining stars to kind of get more ideas that are outside the box, or, even outside the industry, that's another thing too. You know, it doesn't, you don't always have to just look at your industry. Look at sales professionals in other niches that maybe they're doing a few, you know, unique things that you can mix into your style. So,
What makes some of those guys particularly special? I know Kyle Wilson does a ton of video. He's got his own video team now that follows him around. He's also running some video programs. But like some of the other ones, I know Kyle just from obviously EXP Realty and all the, you know, as much as he puts himself out there. But some of the other ones you mentioned, I haven't really heard of them. So what makes their brand, or what kind of video are they putting out there that makes them someone that you should be following?
Great question. This is exactly what the challenge and the playbook is around. It's more so around relatable and likable content. So like Zachary Faust, Taya, they are amazing on TikTok, on Instagram. Glenda Baker, I'm not sure if you know Glenda, but she's amazing with Instagram Reels. We only put agents to follow. We didn't put, you know, like Jason Pantana, I would obviously list him, Tom Ferry. We didn't put like coaches or people that are in the industry. We made sure to only put agents that are, you know, actively, you know, leading or selling as part of the people to follow. But most of these people are rock stars on social media, not so much like on YouTube or on like listing video side. It's more so for like to attract, engage, and delight on social media. That's another emphasis. This is more so for social than it is for YouTube, though we do touch on YouTube because we want you to use it as a hosting source. So like all of your videos you can keep on like a hidden, you know, hidden or private that aren't on your public facing YouTube, but you can still send that to prospects or, you know, send that when need be. But yeah, so all these agents, there's different things that they crush, whether it be IGTV, going, you know, live on IG, doing, you know, deep, you know, internal communications like Kyle, whether for recruiting, whether it be just for his team or agents. There's so many different ideas that we hope to just spark or just, you know, give people. So, it's going to be a great just session. And I'm excited because I want everyone also to come to the session with questions. And as we're going through, you know, write those down. I want this to be interactive and engaging. I want you to ask questions. I'm not afraid to stop and, you know, answer a question and dive back in. And I'm also going to set some time at the very end if we want to actually go through some of your live videos to actually get live critiques or live feedback. I want to make sure that you have my full devoted attention and time, and I want to give back in any way possible. So I don't want to bore you either on this video stuff.
You want to call out my videos that I already critique myself in front of my group?
Hey, if you want me to,
that's the best accountability right there.
Yes. Yeah.
So we've got a studio now at our office here in Altamont that we took, you know, as we expanded our office space and took the broom closet, AC closet, whatever, and put a green screen against the back or blue curtains, and did the soundproof walls and did the carpet for the concrete. And we're recording some YouTube commercials right now. And it's funny because we actually ordered a teleprompter. So Ashley's over there right now setting the iPad up to work off the teleprompter so I can run these commercials, you know, somewhat scripted. Now, I don't recommend going out and running all your videos scripted. These are specific wording we need to be point on and keep the time. But, you know, it's funny as you start recording, you're like, all right, now I need to level up, and I need to level up. You know, not Kyle Whistle-wise, but I loved what you said as well in, you know, it's not just doing Facebook Lives. It's, you've got guys that are crushing TikTok. So, like, I think I'm not a fan of TikTok. My kids are on it all day watching either sports or other people doing stupid stuff. But, you know, agents are crushing TikTok. So why not find an agent who's doing it very well and kind of copy what they're doing, you know, or something. And, you know, Instagram Reels and IGTV, I'm not in those. So it's like, I want to learn how to get involved in that stuff, because the more we can put our brand name across everything, the more attention we're going to get and the more, you know, opportunities we're going to have.
Well, yeah, exactly. Think about, yeah, dude, absolutely right. Think about the shift that's happening. There's a big shift that's happening with Zillow right now. And the big thing is, you want to invest in your personal brand and the experience that you give and you have control over. So there's no better way to do that than social. It's a free platform to get engagement and to attract the type of people that you want to work with, right? So it's about attracting, not chasing. That's the whole goal. So, of course, like, even Google PPC versus Zillow advertising, you have control over the experience. You have control where that user is going, you know, to your website, your brand, your remarketing back to social media. All of that needs to be cohesive and streamlined together for the experience for the consumer. So there's no better way to do that. And I think that's the biggest thing that I want to stress too, is, you know, you want to have your presence on these platforms and have your unique style and have relatable, likable content. But you have to have that stepping stone, that first step, that push off the diving board, right? That's what we're hoping this is going to do for everyone with this playbook and this, you know, video marketing challenge, is just be something where it sparks ideas, sparks inspiration. And then the next step is having that accountability with our Facebook group and us here at Dipity. You know, you can always reach out to us, but we're just excited because this is everything that we firmly believe in. We've heard back from everyone in the industry. Everyone at our conference, video was the number one thing that has grown people's businesses and brands. And like I said, that's, you have control over that experience on social media. So why not utilize that? We're in an amazing era. So the time is now.
Well, it's like what we've got. You know, I've been doing the show just over a year. You're one of our first five guests. And so it's like doing this and running it for a year, hitting almost every week every Friday. And you wouldn't see me normally doing this. And what's funny is that I brought in Daniel Betancourt, one of my partners in the company now, is we're now doing a Monday show. And I was talking with a couple of agents like, yeah, I've been following you. I love what you guys are doing with your videos and putting the content out there and stuff. So it creates a following of people who can get to know your brand. So if you're a team leader, a broker owner wanting to attract agents, this is a way to build your brand out there. If you're an agent that just wants to get out in front of more clients, don't talk about like how to build a real estate business in your videos. It's talk about, you know, the transaction process, or somebody falling in a pool on TikTok. You know, have fun with that stuff.
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. Think about this, right? I mean, If you are a team leader or a broker, you know, you want to work with, or as an agent, if I'm seeking someone to work with, right? Let me rephrase that. If I'm an agent seeking to go to a brokerage or a new team, I want a team or a broker that I can relate to, that I like, that I enjoy being around. So, again, like, of course, educational content and information, you know, is important, but again, like, personality and rapport and trust through likable content, that is one of the best ways to attract and to get recruiting, you know, accomplished as a team leader or broker. So social media content, likable and relatable stuff that is part of this challenge, is also part for recruiting. You know, Kyle Whistle is a great example of that. There's others also. That you can, you know, there's ways to not only just talk about the benefits of going to your brokerage, the systems that you have, the training, you know, the so forth, but again, you know, mix in your culture, your personality, you know, your team, you know, things that are going on, right? Because people want to work with people that they enjoy being around. So it's no different as a client looking to hire you. Clients want to work with people that they like to work with. It's pretty simple, but you need to have your brand and yourself out there to sell your agree that you are somewhat vulnerable, that you attract the people that you want to work with. So, and there's no better way. Like I said, content creates conversations. Conversations create clients. So, video.
I showed our message earlier to one of my team members because we're trying to push them to do a lot of bomb videos. You know, when the lead comes in, let them understand who you are. Let them see you so they know they're talking to a real person. And it's like, what do you say in the initial conversation? Hey, Tyler, this is Todd Schroth. I knew you reached out on our website earlier. I just want to let you know who I am so you know who you're dealing with. When you're ready, reach out. Happy to talk or email or shoot me a video back. Love to get connected and see how we can help you with your real estate needs. And I did that at one of my last events where I sent all the realtors back videos saying thank you for coming. And I made them individual. There was 80 people, so I had to record 80 videos, did it one after the other. And it was literally like minute. And I got a couple videos back from people. What's that?
So an hour and a half total?
About an hour and a half to 2 hours. And I was pretty much done at the end. Because it was a lot of talking. But what's cool is that I had a couple of agents who used the whiteboard and they're like, hey, Todd, and then, you know, send the video back. Yeah. And so it was cool to get a video back from somebody as a response.
Yeah. Oh, Gary V said this perfectly at our conference. He said, you know, and Tom actually does this too as part of his, you know, ecosystem. He actually sends text messages, personalized videos, everything that's one-on-one. And people freak out. You know, it's, you know, so if you take the time, like you said, you know, people understand there's 80 people there, or, you know, it's more of a personalized message. Even when I get videos on my birthday from people that is like, hey, Tyler, happy birthday. You know, I know we haven't talked in a while, but I hope, you know, you and your family are great. Like those just resonate with me. I can still remember people that have sent me videos on my birthday versus just the standard. So, go ahead. I'm sorry.
No, I'll say the best is when our buddy Anthony Malafront goes ahead and sends us our birthday video. It's always 4 days later, just to remind you you're older, and it's not on your birthday. It's always 4 days later. And Anthony, if you're listening to this, I hope you are. I had to peg him because it was 3 days after my birthday. I'm like, Anthony, where's my message to remind me that I'm older, man? Come on. He gets so genuine in the videos, and mm-hmm. it's a minute long. It's on Facebook Messenger or text, whatever, but it's to you. And it's personal about you. So it's like, because he's connecting with his small, viable audience.
Yeah. Just further. So like part of this challenge is, you know, obviously creating content and putting it out there. But we actually don't talk about the engagement after the fact. So it is very important, and you have opportunity to really send those one-on-one videos or voice messages. So as people are commenting on this content, or you're stirring up conversations, or you post it to your story and someone replies back to it, you know, you have an opportunity there to not just send a standard message, but do a quick video or do a quick voice memo in the DM.
Yeah.
And all that stuff matters for engagement. So the more people that you're engaging through social, like through your Instagram, that's part of the algorithm. They'll show you more of that person's content because you're connected deeper than the people that you aren't DMing. So,
yeah. It's good stuff. So for as we wrap up, August 11th from 10 to 12 in Orlando, this is really for the Central Florida audience. We haven't looked at a virtual option yet, but we are going to be hosting with Tyler to go and deep dive into video for the, you know, to really help you grow your real estate business. And we'll have, you know, we'll be getting an email link with an event right out to everybody to get the details. But it's in downtown Orlando at the University Club. We're excited for this, man. I mean, I'm taking my video to a whole new level because never thought I'd be running YouTube commercials and doing different things on video and like doing interviews and doing this stuff. I mean, it's elevated and created a new brand name as well out there. So this is exciting. I'm looking forward to connecting and seeing you again.
Same here, man. I'm super grateful. Thank you for having me. And I'm just excited to give back. And like I said, I have a very valuable session planned for you guys. I put a lot of time into this playbook and this challenge. So I think you're going to be very equipped with what you need to execute with your video efforts moving forward. And then I'll also be there, of course, to answer additional questions, anything that I can do to help. So like I said, I want it to be engaging, come with questions, come with curiosity. Like I said, I don't want you to be afraid to stop me during my session, raise your hand. I enjoy going back and forth because it actually gives me more ideas to think about. So,
I love when people participate because it does make the it makes the event more lively, and it actually gets more information out, things that we might not have talked about.
Absolutely. Yep. I cannot agree more, man. So yeah, I'm super excited. You know, we were chatting before. This is one of the first live events that I'll be going back to in a while. So I'm just excited to just be there in person. And I'm just pumped, man. So thank you for having me. It's our 1 year anniversary. So
yeah. We go from talking about Dippity to we're hosting an event. So this will be good stuff. So guys, Orlando crowd, Central Florida, you know, Tampa to Daytona. I would definitely dive in, check this out. It's going to be from 10 to 12 on the 11th of August at the University Club. We'll be getting more details out on our Facebook page in regards to this. So check out, get some tickets. You're going to love it. Yes. So cool. All right, Tyler, appreciate it.
See you soon.